What goes through your mind when you look down and there's nothing between you and the rest of the planet down there?
I'm pretty positive that one of my main thoughts was, please don't screw this up. Please don't screw this up. A lot of people's work depend on how you're going to perform. Yeah,
and you're on your own because you're going out through the door. Everybody's watching you. It's now your big time, isn't it?
Plus, we went out on the first TVA, July 9th, 2013. We went out in the darkness. We went through the sunset as we were getting out. So my first view was of pure blackness. But I said, I'm good. Let's start work right away. I was out and I'm like, this is good. And you know what? I really felt at home. I felt so good. I was, you know, I was I had felt energetic and I was pumped up and I'm like, I got this. This is my spacesuit. I know how to move in this thing. So this is still in the darkness. I have this huge piece of equipment. And so Karen inside is moving me with the robotic arm from one side of the station to another. It takes about 6 or 7 minutes.
Yeah.
And then I have this huge, huge luxury. I have nothing to do in an EVA, which is really rare because usually you're always doing something. So I couldn't take a picture because my arms were busy. All I could do was look outside. And at the moment, while I was over the Atlantic Ocean, the sunrise came. Now, this is the moment that you're looking for. And I cannot describe my feelings, but I can tell you what I saw. And then you can imagine what I felt.
Now, your second spacewalk was a little bit more eventful. I mean, obviously, if anybody knows about your career, you had a leak in the suit, which effectively ended up you being, you described it as being like a goldfish bowl from the inside.
After only about maybe 20 or 30 seconds, I turned the corner. The space station is big, but it's not that big. You just have to navigate in three dimensions. So you have to imagine, and even though I was maybe 85 feet away from the hatch, I'm navigating through this jungle gym of parts that you cannot touch. It's very delicate. You have to follow very specific paths. In a second, I was upside down. I couldn't see anything anymore. I couldn't breathe through my nose. I couldn't hear anything. And I felt very isolated. So even though I could breathe through my mouth, the thought at the moment was, how much water is there in this helmet? And how much time do I have before it fills up?